Okay, hi. This is Father Jerry Orbos, SVD. Kumusta po kayong lahat? You CFL parents, especially. May I begin by saluting you parents. Salamat po sa lahat ng mga pagmamahal, mga sakripisyo. You know, we can never measure yung mga ginawa nyo at ginagawa nyo para sa mga anak. Please don't forget, this is your mission and that God will give you the grace you need. So you need to hold on to the Lord, ask for guidance, ask for strength and perseverance. Siguro, you know, I was just thinking, just when you thought, nagawa mo na lahat para mapalaki yung bata. Nung lumaki, naku, marami na naman, marami pa palang mga problema. Parenting never ends. So, this is your life mission. It's your ticket to heaven, mga kapatid. To raise good, loving children, good Catholics, good Filipinos, and good persons, of course. So, ano po ba ang role ng mga parents? Isipin po yung tatlong C. Nung bata pa yung mga bata, C, you are the controller. Of course, somebody had to control them. Hindi tama yan, ganun, ganun. You were there. You were the boss. Okay? Very good. Lumaki yung mga bata, as they grow older, you become na lang a coach. Anak, maganda yata doon. Siguro maganda doon. Kino-coach mo na lang sila. Kasi pag lumaki na sila, controller ka pa rin, oo, problema niyan, clash. You have to grow up with them. And the third level, they're grown up, the third C, consultant ka na lang. You're just, when you're asked to, then you give your idea. In other words, malaki na sila at controller ka pa rin, malaking problema. You grow up with them. And you know, parents, this is the big letting go and letting God. I'm sure you always say, Father, I mean well. You know, they need to do this. Dapat. Yeah, well-meaning people end up mean. Sabi mo, eh, because kasi kailangan nila, you know. Okay, kaya lang in the end, baka lalo lang hindi maganda pong resulta. Letting go and letting God. At this point of their lives, naitanim na po ninyo yung mga basics. If you have prepared well when they were young, it will be there. Don't worry. The goodness is there and it's never gone. So I pray for you all to accept and maybe ask yourself, maybe I have not graduated from a controller. Kaya maraming problema. So that's the way to go. From a controller, you become a coach. Consultant. That's the way it goes. Mahirap po ang role ng parents, especially this time. Iba na po ang pag-iisip ng mga millennials sa kay mga Z generation. Iba. Aba, eh, minsan may nag-text sa akin. Martin, Mendoza, Father, give me a shout out in your mass tomorrow. Shout out, sabi ko. Oh, sa lublub ko, no? My God, all my life as a priest, I never shouted at anyone at mass. I've never sent out anyone at mass. Yun pala ang ibig sabihin ng shout out is a greeting. So many things we don't understand. Parang yung may nag-text. Okay, Father, yeah, thank you. And then sabi niya, mua-mua. Oh, ano yung mua-mua na yan? Di nag-text ako, mua-mua ka rin. I don't even know what that meant that time. Pero pa nag-text na, at the end said, chup-chup. Anong chup-chup? Di nag-text din ako, ketchup. Ketchup. But the worst was one time may nag-text po sa akin. Oh, I know, I texted the priest, kaibigan na pare. Nag-text ako, a joke, aba, nag-text back siya, LOL, lul. Sabi ko, pambihira naman to. How mean, how disrespectful. Kasi akala ko, lol means ulol, you know, fool. Yung pala ang ibig sabihin niya ay, laughing out loud. So there you go. I can imagine the adjustments you have to make. But keep this in mind. Whatever you encounter, there's nothing like talking it over. Anak, paano ba ito? Anak, kumusta ka na? Don't go to the point of nagging them. Pag adult na yan, wag na yung nagging. You respect them. And so, one of the things you should learn is what I say, stop playing the game of eyes. I-C-E. I is the game of impositions. Baka ang dami kang imposition sa kanila. I want this, dapat ganito kayo. Ang standard nyo dapat ganito, 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 ganito. You know, if you begin to be very imposing, may mga kung dyan eh, nagre-rebelde. Ang tao pong nag-i-impose, ang tawag sa kanya ay impostor. Father, I mean well. They have to know. They have to be good. I mean well. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I know you mean well. But you can end up mean. No, I think this is not the time anymore for impositions. Sisters and brothers, check yourself. Maybe it's the time to listen. Respect, suggest. The second is the game of C, control. As I said kanina, controlling ka. You control everything and everyone. Kinontrol mo na yung anong kurso nila, yung mga love life nila, kinukontrol mo lahat. Oh my God, may backfire po yan. Mayroon at mayroong backfire po. Stop controlling. You have to respect and believe. Believe that the goodness you have planted is there. Yeah. Oh, husbands. Gusto ba niyong kinokontrol kayo ni misis? Who wants to be controlled? See? And one of the other thing is E, problema, expectations. Baka marami kang expectations. I expect you to go to Mass. I expect you to pray the rosary. Yeah. Huwag ka na lang mag-expect po. I'm not trying to say na walang kwenta na yun. No. The point is, at this point, you can just suggest. And don't feel bad when your expectations don't come. They are not fulfilled. You have to believe that God is working in them in ways you don't know. Trust the goodness of the children. Yeah, what else can you do? Otherwise, you go to the sunset disappointed, feeling that you're a failure, etc., etc. So, I like you to imagine Mama Mary. If Mama Mary played the game of eyes, imposition, control, and expectations on Jesus, do you think Jesus could have done his mission for the Father? Baka imbis na natulungan niya, siya pang naging balakid, became the block that this child could not do his or her mission with the Heavenly Father. we mean well, but you must believe that the child has his own way. Itong mali po ng maraming parents. Don't prepare the road for the child. Prepare the child for the road, whatever road is up ahead. Ang ginagawa kasi ng mga iba, pinaplansa nila itong dadaanan mo, anak ha, itong kurso mo, itong lahat, kukontrolin mo hanggang makita mo. It's better to prepare a child for the road. Whatever road he will take, he'll be okay. And one of the things I know is the prayer life. Sometimes, maybe, the child relates with God not in the way you expected it or you want it, but still believe that the child has that value. And keep encouraging. Huwag sabihin na, wala na mga anak ko. Wow. And it's painful, I know, for parents, especially, bakit nag-ibang religion, Father? Anong nangyari? Yeah, I can feel your pain. But look, you've done what you could do. Now, when things don't turn out the way you expect it, in humility, just come to God and say, Lord, I've done my best. To you, I leave the rest. Maybe that's what we have to learn from Mama Mary. She always had to let go. I'm sure Mama Mary would have wanted, Jesus, huwag ka nang pumunta doon sa Jerusalem. Dito ka na lang sa Nazareth. Jesus, huwag ka nang mag-preach ng kung ano-ano. You know? Imagine the pain of Mama Mary. But in everything, she trusted in God and let go. I'm one with you in prayer. And please don't be disappointed. Don't feel sad. Somewhere down the road, I know the Lord will never abandon your child. That's how you should believe also. Lord, mahal po nyo ang batang yan at hindi po nyo pababayaan. Keep praying. All the more you pray. Don't fret, you pray. Okay? So mga kapatid, one with you in your mission, mahirap po. And God bless you for the many good things you have done. And huwag po tayong mawawalan ng pag-asa. You have to learn to let go. Because if you play the game of eyes, impositions, control, and expectations, you know what happens to the children? They'll get frozen. And what do you do kung frozen? What's that song in the movie? Let it go. Yun. Let's sing it nga. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Speaking words of wisdom. Let it go. Wow, nag-shift, no? And maybe that's one of the things I like to remind you. Humor. You have to learn how to be joyful. That sense of humor, to see something beautiful happening in spite of difficulties. I went through cancer 2018. How did I go through all that? Well, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Focus on the humor, not on the tumor. Same. When you look at your life, count your blessings, not what is missing. Parenting should be a joyful mission, in spite of disappointments, failures, trials, because you parent with God. You become a parent with Mama Mary. That is the secret. And again, for the younger generations too, kasi ang problema maraming parents, you were so focused on the IQ, dapat matalino yung bata, so education, it's all IQ. So you have children who grow up na full of knowledge, smart, pero kulang ng the second one, EQ, emotional quotient. Teach the children not only to be smart, but to be loving, to be respectful, to be kind, to be generous. I remember when we were young, growing up in Bani, Pangasinan, mahirap ang buhay. But I remember this, may mga pulubi, may mga lumalapit. Papa and Mama always told us, you give them something, kahit ano, magbigay tayo. And many times, Papa would put even a coin, sige Jerry, bigay mo. Hawak niya, tinuturo niya sa amin, magbigay. Ang dami kasing mga bata, smart but so unkind, so angry. That's the third one, SQ, IQ, intelligence, EQ, emotional quotient, SQ, social quotient. Na marunong silang may kahalubilo, maging humble, maging cooperative. They know how to blend, how to work with a team. Hindi sila anti-social. Panay na lang computer. Teach them that. Oh, may isa pa, mga kapatid. AQ. Adversity quotient. Adversity quotient means teach them how to be strong when they experience failures, disappointments, hurts. Kasi mga ibang bata ngayon, pag na-disappoint, hindi lang siya na-like sa Facebook, aba, na-depressed, mayroon bang nag-suicide? Teach the children that pain is part of life. Failures, disappointments. And how do you do all that? Ang dami, no? Ang laking bagay po yung prayer life, yung religion natin. You teach them that there is a God who's telling all of us, emotionally, socially, and in adversity, to listen to Him. Go back to the basics po, mga kapatid. So, good luck, dear parents. Mahirap po. But this is your mission. And continue to pray for the children. And Papa and Mama always told us when we were young, our greatest joy yung nakikita namin nagmamahalan kayo. Our greatest sadness is kung may away-away kayo. I mean, what parent will not tell that? Di po ba? And there was another thing Mama and Papa taught us. I'd be so happy, sabi ni Mama and Papa, if someday at the end of our lives, we all will be in heaven, complete as a family, all in heaven, final reunion. And I'll be so sad, sabi ni Mama and Papa, if one of you will not make it to heaven, will not be complete as a family anymore. Words of wisdom, simple words of wisdom. I pray for all of you in your journey. Pray especially for members of your family who need love most. So with this, I invite you all now to pray with me. We honor you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We honor you, Mama Mary, dear Mother. Today, we thank you again for the gift of family. Thank you for couples who have embraced God and who allow God to embrace them. Bless and reward the parents who do so much untold sacrifices and love. We lift up to you our family, Lord, all members of the family, living or dead, present or absent, especially members of the family who need healing, who need forgiveness, who need conversion, who need provisions. Give us peace and unity. And this is a difficult time for all of us because of the pandemic. Sana po, Lord, maging matatag kami. A family that prays together, stays together. Lord, bless our families, our loved ones. Bless our country, the Philippines. Bless the world with your peace. Thank you, Lord. Dear friends, continue to stand for family, to stand for life. I bless you all in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. God bless you, and Mama Mary loves you.